Hi, I'm Dr. Ana Cristina. I'm the Senior Food Scientist here at the Canadian Food and Wine Institute Innovation Center at Niagara College. As a food scientist, I create new foods for people. It's our job as a food scientist to make sure that the food that we deliver, it tastes really, really good, and also is healthy for you and safe for you. Today, we're gonna do an experiment. Have you noticed at home sometimes the brownie is a little too tough or too chewy or too soft? We need to understand why that happens. We're gonna make 5 brownies using 5 different flours, and we're gonna see how the texture turns out. Flours come from different sources. We're gonna find out which of the flours is giving us the best texture for the brownie. If we look inside that flour, we're gonna find the molecules that are called starches. As a scientist, we look inside that flour, very, very good, super ice. And then we're gonna find some lines and some branches. Those lines is called amylose. And those branches is called amylopectin. When we have lots of those lines in the flour, that brownie is gonna be tough because the amylose forms a gel that is very, very strong. If we have lots of branches in the flour, those branches are gonna form like a slime and the brownie is gonna be soft. So which flour is the best? Let's find out. Alright, so we cook our brownies, they're ready to go, and we can see the difference in brownies. The potato starch, it has lots of lines. So, our brownie is really tough. We have this waxy starch that comes from tapioca, and it has more branches in it, meaning that our brownie is really soft. This starch here is a rice starch. You can see it forms a gel, not as strong as the potato starch. So this is good for a brownie that we don't want it to be too tough when you bite it. It has some body on it, but it's still soft at the same time. So which starch is the best? Well, it depends what brownie do you like. Do you like a tough brownie? Do you like a chewy brownie? Do you like it a little soft? How you like your brownie, you can choose the starch you would like. My favorite is the rice starch. I love it. I decided to be a food scientist because I love science. I love math. I love chemistry. I love biology. I wanted to apply that science to something that I can see the outcome right away. I love my job because I get to understand the science behind every single ingredient to make delicious, healthy, safe food. If you want to be a food scientist, it's because you love food. Also because you're creative. You like to create different foods, use different ingredients. And also because you like to understand why things happen. You want to know the science behind it. And this is how you're going to become a very good food scientist.